Good morning. So let's begin our analysis of how error detection and correction can happen in linear block codes using the parity check matrix. In the previous class, we have discussed the parity check matrix is very important in detection and correction of errors in linear block codes. Let's see how this works. So let us assume the code vector C to have n bits. We know it will have n bits in this form, and the received vector R to also have n bits in this form, R1, R2, so on up to Rn. Now, we can say also let there be an error vector E, which consists of n bits E1, E2, so on up to En. Remember, whenever the code vector passes through a channel, it is prone to error. The channel can induce error in the bits, and the errors induced we are defining as the error vector. Now, if the received vector is equal to the transmitted code vector, then we say error vector would be zero. Yes or no? But if R is not equal to the transmitted code vector, then the error vector will be non-zero. This can also be said in the format as what? If I consider it bit by bit, if I'm going to take it one bit at a time, I'll say if the received vector RI is equal to the transmitted code bit vector or the code bit CI, then the error bit EI is zero. Or if RI, the received code bit, is not equal to the corresponding transmitted code bit, then the error bit will be one. Simple. We are talking in terms of binary. The error bit can either be 0 or 1. If the received code bit is equal to the transmitted code bit at the corresponding value of I, then the error bit would be 0 at that position. Whereas if the received bit is not equal to the transmitted bit, then the error bit would be 1. So let's consider here with this case, we can define, therefore, let me say, we can now define an n minus k bit vector to measure if there is an error in the received signal. So if there is an error in the received signal, I'll be able to detect that. Okay, to detect or measure if there is an error in the received signal, this is called as the syndrome vector or the syndrome error calculation syndrome. Okay, so this is called as the syndrome vector, and it is defined as S in terms of matrix or in terms of vectors, which is 1 cross n minus k. I have n minus k columns and one row is R which is 1 cross n, 1 row and n columns, R into H transpose. Remember, we have the parity check matrix H. If we take the transpose of that matrix, it would be of order n cross n minus k. Okay, so in general, this error computation syndrome or the error calculation syndrome S is defined as the received vector R into the H transpose matrix. This is an important result. Now, let's try to analyze why this is true. So, if we try to check why this is true, let me just move this. Yeah. So, okay. To prove that S is proportional to the error. I have to prove that S is proportional to the error. So how do we go about proving this? Let's say we know that S is equal to R into H transpose. All are matrices, okay? Also, what is R? The received vector is always equal to the transmitted code vector plus the error vector. So we know that there will always be some error in the channel. So that error gets added to the transmitted code vector, and therefore the received vector will always be transmitted code vector plus error, right? So this was called equation A. This is equation B. Let's say substituting equation B in A, what do we get? S is equal to C plus E into H transpose. In place of R, we have substituted C plus E, which means C into H transpose plus E into H transpose. And what do we know among these two elements? We have already proved C into H transpose is zero. That means if we multiply a valid code vector with the H transpose matrix, we are always going to get zero as the result. So what would this be equal to? This would simply be equal to E into H transpose. So what have we proved now? Therefore, the syndrome vector is always proportional to the error vector, or syndrome is a measure of error occurring in the circuit. Syndrome is a measure of error. So if I compute this syndrome vector, I'll be able to detect whether there is an error in the received vector or not, right? Note, let me say, if S is zero, if the syndrome is zero, then no error, and R would be equal to C. The received vector would be same as the transmitted code vector. If syndrome is non-zero, then an error has occurred. An error has occurred. And what should we do? If an error has occurred, we should detect the error, right? Error has occurred. We have detected the error. And let's say to detect the position of error, what should we do? We compare the syndrome. So whatever syndrome we have, we compare it with rows of the H transpose matrix. Rows of H transpose matrix. And the matching row gives the position of error. So I have also detected the error and I have also obtained the position of error. Okay, so you'll understand this clearly when we go through an example. What you should remember is, if at all the syndrome is zero, then there is no error and the received vector is same as the transmitted code vector. But if it is not zero, if I get a non-zero syndrome, it means an error has occurred and I have to find in which position the error has occurred. So what we'll do, we'll take that syndrome vector. It's an n minus k bit vector. We'll take it and compare it with the rows of the H transpose matrix. And whichever row matches, that particular row would be the position of error. If I count the bits from left, so if I start counting the bits from the left in the received vector, the position of the matching row, that particular bit counting from the left is the position of error in the received vector. Okay. So with this, there are two ways of determining correcting the vector. So we will observe which are those two ways of correcting the vector as we solve this problem. I'll just tell you briefly here. The two ways of correcting it are, therefore, to correct, what we can do. One is flip the bit position of R which is in error. So we have already found that position number by analyzing the matching row. So you just have to flip that bit position. You will get that as the position that will be the corrected code vector. So to correct, you can either do this, or the next thing what you can do is define an error vector E with one in the corresponding bit position, the matching bit position of the row. In that corresponding bit position, you have to write a 1. Okay. So in all other positions, it will be 0. Whichever position matches, there you're going to put a 1 in the error vector. And then what should you do? Add E with the received vector. So now you take this error vector and add it to the received vector. Then you will get the corrected code vector. We'll call it as C cap. The transmitted vector, we are calling it as C. Let the corrected code vector be C cap. So these are the two possible ways of correcting the error. Let's try to analyze and use these in the next example problem. So as you can see here, we have to consider a 7,4 linear block code with the parity matrix given as shown. You have to find G, H, that is generator, and the parity check matrices, first thing. And if there are three received vectors, R1, R2, R3, as shown, determine if there was any error during transmission. Also detect and correct the error. So let's try to solve this. First thing is, I have to write G and H matrices. How do I define G? Normally, G is written as identity appended with parity. So here, I have to write an identity matrix of what is the K value? K value is 4, N value is 7. So I4 appended with the parity matrix. Order of parity matrix will be what? 4 rows and 3 columns, right? So you can now easily write this. So what would be I4? 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Third row this is. Last row, fourth row would be 0, 0, 0, 1. Correct. Now, I have to write the parity matrix which is already given here. So I'll just concatenate it. 0, 1, 1 was the first row. 1, 0, 1 was the second row. 1, 1, 0, third row. And 1, 1, 1, last row. Hence, we have got a matrix of order K cross N or 4 cross 7. We are done with writing the generator matrix. Let me next write. So let me next write the parity check matrix. Or here, H. You remember how H is defined? If the generator is defined in the form identity and parity, then H would be defined in the form parity transpose appended to identity. And please remember the order of the identity matrix would be N minus K here rather than N. Okay. So here, yeah. So let me write this matrix. This would be, we already know the parity matrix. This is our parity matrix, right? I should take the transpose of that parity matrix, which means the rows will change into columns. This row would now be the first column. 0, 1, 1, the first row in the parity would become the first column. Second row, 1, 0, 1 would be the second column. Third row, 1, 1, 0, third column. And the last row would be the fourth column. And this would give your parity transpose matrix. Please see, the parity matrix is of order 4 cross 3. Its transpose should be 3 cross 4 as we have obtained here. Okay. Now I should include an identity matrix of order N minus K. 7 minus 3 means 7 minus 4 is 3. So an identity matrix of order 3, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. This would give me the H matrix whose order is 3 cross 7. N minus K cross N. Okay. This is K cross N. So we are done with the first part of the solution. Now let's consider the second part where they say three different received vectors are obtained. So I have R1, R2 and R3. You have to determine if there was an error. That is, you should detect if there was an error during transmission. And also you have to correct that error. So let me try to do that. Let me first try to note down the received vector before I move forward. R1 is 0, 1 followed with all zeros. Okay. 7 bit it should be received vector. And R2 is 111, 0, 111, and R3 is 1100, 100. Okay. So with this, I have to first write. All of us know, how do we detect whether there is an error or not? I can detect if there is an error or not by finding the syndrome vector. So if I find the syndrome vector as the received vector into the H transpose matrix, I'll know if there was an error. So what should I do? Take this received vector 0, 1 followed with all zeros, 5, 6, 7, and multiply it with the H transpose matrix. This was our H matrix. I should take transpose of this. Ideally speaking, it will have the parity matrix and the identity matrix one below the other, because this was P transpose and I n minus k. H transpose would be what? Transpose of this matrix means P transpose of transpose, which would be P, and I n minus k transpose would be I n minus k itself, because identity matrices are square matrices, right? So let me write this. We have 0, 1, 1. 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1, correct? This is the parity matrix. Then the identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So now I have to multiply. If I multiply, I told you the best way of multiplying binary numbers or binary matrices is to match the positions of ones. See, luckily in this received vector, we have one only at the second bit position. So in each column, remember multiplication is row into column, yes or no? So when I multiply this with each column, I just have to check the second bit position. So here, this second bit position, it is a one, which means the multiplication of the whole vector with this first column would result in 1, because it is 0 at all other positions. It would be 0 plus 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0, all zeros. Only second bit position is 1, so it will remain as a 1. Similarly, multiplying this with the second column, the second bit position should be compared. That second bit position here is a 0, and here all other bits are 0. So this will remain a 0, 1 into 0. And finally, this row multiplied with the third column, compare the second bit position, which is again a 1. So I'm going to get the syndrome vector as 1, 0, 1. As you can notice, it is a 1 cross n minus k bit vector. According to this, it is a 1 cross 3 vector. So now, how do I get the corrected code word? The corrected code word C1 dash can be obtained in the first method by simply flipping that bit position to which row this syndrome matches. So when I match this syndrome to H transpose, can you tell me to which row this is matching? You can see clearly this is matching to the second row, right? So second row matches. It matches with second row. Therefore, what would be the correct code vector? The second bit position in R1 should be changed. So whatever is there in the second bit position, you just have to flip it. You just change the second bit position, you'll be getting the corrected code vector. So this is the first method of correcting the code vector. I hope I am clear. Now, let's try to solve the second part of this, or for the second received vector, let's try to do the same thing. So I have to calculate the syndrome S2 as R2 into H transpose, and we know R2 is 111111 as shown here, and H transpose is the same 011101 110111, and to this I have to append the identity 100010 and 001. So we can multiply this received vector into H transpose, and as I told you, all you need to do is match the corresponding bit positions. Here there are many ones, so I have to compare bit position 1 and 1, it's a 0. Second bit position is a 1. Third bit position is a 1, so add. And remember, all additions are modulo 2. Okay, the fourth bit position is a 0. Fifth bit position is a 1. So I'll get 1 plus 1 plus 1, modulo 2 addition. Similarly, if I multiply this with the second column, again, the first bit position is a 1. The second bit position is a 0, so it will be not included. Third bit position is a 1, it should be included. The fourth bit position is a 0 here. Even at one place it is 0, then it can be excluded. Fifth bit position, the fifth bit position is a 0 here. Sixth bit position is a 1. The seventh bit position is a 0 here. So again, I'm going to get 3 ones. And the last column into this row vector, 1 and 2 bit positions are ones, whereas the third bit position is a 0 here, fourth is a 0 here, fifth and sixth are zeros here, but the seventh is a 1 in both places. So I'm going to get the syndrome something like this. You just have to do modulo 2 addition. What would it be? If we do modulo 2 addition, this would give me, whenever I add 3 ones, right? So always addition of 3 ones is a 1. It's like XOR operation. Odd number of ones will give you 1. So you're going to get 1, 1, 1. Okay? So you need not include this comma. Even if you include, it's not wrong. What is the value you're going to get? You're going to get 1, 1, 1. Now what should you do? Match it with H transpose. Match with H transpose and see which row matches. See, I have 1, 1, 1 in fourth, right? Fourth row of H transpose is 1, 1, 1. So it matches with fourth row. Let me use the second method here. The second method of correcting the error. What does it say? Define the error vector, or rather than if, I'll say now. Now, error vector is defined with a 1 in the fourth bit position. So whichever row matches with the syndrome, that bit position should be made as 1. And you have to add what? To get the corrected code vector, I have to add this error pattern with the received vector R2 in this case. So if I bring this received vector and add it to this, what do you think will happen? All other positions where it is 0, the corrected code vector will remain same as this. So I'm going to get 1, 1, 1 for the first 3 bit positions. Only this fourth bit position where it is a 1, 1 plus 0 will give you a 1. And again, remaining 3 bit positions are zeros here. If you add, you're going to get 1, 1, 1. So this would represent the corrected code vector in this second case of received vector. Likewise, we can solve for the third case also. So here S3 is R3 into H transpose. R3 is given as 1 11 00 100 and H transpose we have just like before. And if you try solving this, just like how we did there, you will be getting the answer as, I think we would get the answer here as, most probably, 1 0 1 0. So this will result in answer in the same way we should do. Just like how I showed you, we should multiply here. In the same pattern, if you multiply row with column and match the corresponding one positions and do a modulo 2 addition, you'll get this syndrome vector. And now this matches with which row? It matches with 0, 1, 0 matches with what? Sixth row of H transpose, which means the error pattern will be all zeros except a one in the sixth bit position. Therefore, the corrected code vector would be E plus R3, which would only do the same action as flipping the sixth bit. We are adding a one only to the sixth bit position. So it would just flip that sixth bit position. I would get all other bits as the same. Okay. So this is how we detect and correct errors in circuits. Error detection and correction happens using the parity check matrix, or let me say the transpose of the parity check matrix to be exact. And if we define the error syndrome as received vector into transpose of parity check matrix, we'll be able to get an n minus k bit vector. If that vector is 0, then that signifies no error. The code vector has been received correctly. But if it is not 0, then it surely signifies error and it has to be corrected. Okay, so with this background, let's move on to the syndrome calculation circuit. So just like how we did the encoder hardware, we should also do hardware for syndrome calculation circuit. For that, we'll start off with the definition which we know. We know that the syndrome is defined as R into H transpose. We have only defined this. To detect for errors, we will compute the syndrome, which is a n minus k bit vector. So if I expand this equation, expanding equation 1, what do I get? S1, S2, so on till Sn minus k. Okay, it's an n minus k bit vector, 1 cross n minus k is equal to, here R is a n bit vector, R1, R2, so on until Rn. So this is a 1 cross n received vector. And the H transpose matrix, I will have P11, P12, the parity bits until P1 n minus k. Okay. Similarly, P21, P22, so on, P2 n minus k. Likewise, coming down the kth bit, PK1, PK2, so on, PK n minus k. So expanding, we will get S1, S2, Sn minus k. The n minus k syndrome bits would be equal to the n received bits R1 to Rn into the H transpose matrix, which can be written as the parity matrix followed by the identity matrix of order n minus k. So this is how we have written all the values. Now I'll call this as equation 2. From equation 2, we can write the first syndrome bit S1 is equal to, I just have to multiply this row vector with every column, R1 into P11 plus R2 into P21, okay, the second bit into this, so on, plus RK, let me take one value, RK in the center, into PK1, remember this will be the kth bit, right, plus the next bit after this, the next bit after this would be RK plus 1, right, that RK plus 1 should get multiplied with 1 into 1, and the remaining bits till Rn, whatever other bits we get till Rn, will all be zeros. So this represents the expression for S1. Similarly, we can write the expression for the second syndrome bit as this received vector into the second column. So I'll get R1 into P12, R2 into P22, so on. Here, RK into PK2. So the kth bit here will get multiplied with this bit, because on this side also, this is the kth bit. But here, RK plus 1 will get multiplied with 0, whereas RK plus 2 will get multiplied with 1. So on, add zeros. This corresponds to the syndrome vector S2 or the syndrome bit S2. Similarly, the last syndrome bit Sn minus k can be defined as R1 into the last column P1 n minus k plus R2 into P2 n minus k plus so on. RK plus 1, I need not worry because this identity matrix is 0 in all places. So the last bit here is Rn. Rn gets multiplied with 1. It is 0 at many places in between. Okay. So I can write linear equations defining the syndrome bits with the received bits and the parity bits. And when we do this, this will help us in getting a realization and drawing the syndrome calculator circuit. Therefore, the hardware needed for syndrome calculation circuit first thing, looking at these linear equations, I need an n-bit shift register. So you need an n-bit shift register to store the received vector. So to store the received vector, I need an n-bit shift register. Next, I need how many modulo 2 adders? Remember, all the adders what we have written, all addition symbols are modulo 2 additions only. So I'll need to calculate n minus k syndrome bits, a maximum of n minus k modulo 2 adders. So you need max of n minus k modulo 2 adders. And what else do we need? We need the parity bits. Those parity bits can either be realized using multipliers or switches. Multipliers or switches to realize the parity bits Pij. Okay. So with all these things, now let's try to realize these equations. So it would be very simple to realize these equations. I'll consider it here. First thing, the received vector is passed on to what? A shift register of how many bits? 7-bit shift register. So R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7. So we have a 7-bit shift register. And next we are going to have N minus K mod 2 adders. Let me first consider the adder for the first. Let me just write one adder which will yield the syndrome bit S1. Okay. And the next adder which would yield the syndrome bit S2, and the third adder which yields the syndrome bit S3. Now I just have to make out what are the inputs to each of these adders. Sorry, S2, S3. This goes on till Sn minus k. So I'll go on having many such values. Let me consider the first and the last. The inputs, the in-between values can be filled up accordingly. So for the first syndrome bit, I have to consider R1 into P11. So R1 multiplied with the parity bit P11 is the first one. R2 multiplied with P21. So on, R3 multiplied with P31, this continues, and I have written only till R7 here. This should extend, this will extend till Rn. R1 to Rn I am going to have, okay? This would be P, what is there in the equation? We have Rn is not part of it, I think. So what do we have? Yeah, for Rn it is 0. What should I include then? So I shouldn't include. I need the value of Rk plus 1. So let me do one thing. Let me consider R7 as Rk plus 1. For example, in this case, if this is Rk plus 1, this I have to directly connect to this. So I will have many in-between values where I'm going to multiply the individual received bits with the parity bits. And finally, this Rk plus 1 will be included directly. So the syndrome bit S1 will be generated. Likewise, let me see how the syndrome bit Sn minus k can be generated. So look at the last part of the equation. R1 here, I'll tap R1 from here. And what should it be multiplied with? R1 should be multiplied with P1 n minus k. And it should be connected to this last modulo 2 adder. R2 should be multiplied with P2 n minus k, again fed to the last adder, and Rn will be directly connected to this, and in between I'm going to have many more values. So this is just an example realization of a syndrome calculation circuit, also known as the syndrome calculation grant. It is often called as syndrome calculation grant. I hope you understood how this could be done. Now, based on this, let's consider an example. Let me consider the same or a similar problem which we had considered here. example, problem, let's say, given the parity matrix 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 1. This is the given parity matrix for a 7,4 linear block code. Draw the syndrome calculator circuit. Draw the syndrome calculator circuit. Also detect if there are any errors in the received vector. In the received vector, let me say R1 is 11 00 00 11, and correct the errors using an error correction circuit. Yeah. So this problem becomes interesting because of addition of error correction circuit. Let's try to see how to solve this problem. So the solution would be, the first step is to find the syndrome equations. So we know that syndrome is defined as R into H transpose, which can be written as R1 R2. How many bits will be there in the received vector? N bits, 7 bits here. R4 R5 R6 R7. So we have 7 bits in the received vector multiplied with the H transpose matrix. So as I told you, the H transpose matrix should have parity and then it should have identity. So just repeat these parity matrix bits as they are 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 1, and next I should have identity matrix of order 3, n minus k, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So the overall order of this matrix will be n into n minus k, which is 7 into 3, 7 rows and 3 columns. This would be 1 cross 7. Okay, and the syndrome would have what? It's an n minus k bit vector, so 1 cross n minus k, which is 3. Now from this I can find the linear equation. Therefore, S1, the first syndrome bit here, if you want, you can write it as S1 S2 S3, so you can get a one-on-one mapping with the equation. What would S1 be, the first bit? This complete row vector into the first column. So R1 into 1, which would give you R1, okay, plus R2 into 0, it shouldn't be included, plus R3 into 1, so R3 should be there, plus R4 into 1, R4 should be there, plus R5 into 1. Plus R5 into 1. Therefore, the first syndrome bit S1 can be obtained using modulo 2 addition of all these 4 bits. Okay. Similarly, the second syndrome bit S2 is multiplication of this with the second row. What would you get? R1 into 0. So wherever there is a 1, that particular bit in the received vector should be included. R2 XOR, R3 XOR, R4 XOR, R6. So I have S2 to be calculated like this. Next, let's see the last bit S3. We have ones in first, second, fourth, and seventh positions. So it would be R1, R2, R4 plus R7. So I have the three syndrome bits calculated in this fashion. Now, how do I draw the syndrome calculation circuit? The syndrome calculation circuit would be simply realization of these three bits. In the sense, I should have a shift register. So what does this require? In hardware, I need to have 7-bit shift register to store R. Next, you need 3 modulo 2 adders to get the syndrome vector. And along with that, I need some switches or multipliers, which we will normally realize using switches. Okay. So let's try to draw this circuit. First thing, I should draw a 7-bit shift register. R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, and R7. Yes. Next, I need to have 3 modulo 2 adders. So I am going to consider adder 1, adder 2, and adder 3. This will give you bit S1. This would give you bit S2, and this would give you bit S3. Now, look at the first equation S1. It's a combination of R1, R3, R4, and R5. So all what I have to do is bring the corresponding bits as input to this modulo 2 adder. R1, R3, R4, and R5. Done. I was telling you before also, if you are confused, just write those bit values R1, R3, R4, R5. It will remove the confusion. Similarly, for the next S2, R2, R3, R4, and R6 are input. So I'll take the corresponding bits. R2, R3 is already there. R3, R4, and R6. Done. So we have the 4 input bits to generate the second syndrome bit. And coming to the last syndrome bit, the inputs are R1, R2, R4, and R7. So I have R1, R2, R2, R4, and finally R7. So we are able to generate the three syndrome bits using this syndrome calculator circuit. Now, the question turns interesting because he has asked us to take one received vector and detect if there are any errors first. So if we find the syndrome, we will detect if there is an error, and we should also correct the errors using an error calculation circuit. So let me first try to detect the errors. You say here, let me continue here itself. Given received vector is 110001. So I have to find if there is an error. Therefore, S is R into H transpose 11. You can also just directly take the corresponding bit values and add here. If you don't want to multiply, you have an option of finding. So what is S1? S1 is R1, R3, R4, R5. R1, R3, R4, R5. You take those corresponding bit values and add. 1, R3 is 0, R4 is 0, and R5 is also 0. So what do I get? I get a 1 here. R1, R3, R4, R5. Correct? I think, yeah. Next, here itself we have. Next is the bit S2. You can compute as R2, R3, R4, and R6. R2, R3, R4, and R6. Here R2 is 1, R3 is 0, R4 is 0, R6 is 1. So here I'll get a 1 plus 1, which is a 0 in modulo 2 addition. Next, S3 is obtained as R1, R2 plus R4 plus R7. Take the corresponding bits. R1, R2 plus R4 plus R7, which will also give me a 1 because there are 3 bits which are high. So finally, the syndrome vector would be 101, which means there is error. There is error in the received vector. So how do we correct this error? We know how to correct this error using the normal method. Therefore, you say error correction circuit should be drawn. Here he says you also devise an error correction circuit for the same. How would we do that? What is the method of identifying error? To identify error or to correct error, what do we do? The position is identified. Error bit position. Error bit position is the matching row of H transpose. Matching row of H transpose with the syndrome. Yes or no? With the syndrome vector. We'll use the same concept here to draw an error correction circuit. So what I'll do, make a list of all possible syndromes. Where do I get it? This is readily available to me. All possible syndromes are, it is nothing but your H transpose matrix. So you have the H transpose matrix, which states, I think, where did we, 101, 011, 110, 111, 100, 00, 001. This was our H transpose matrix. So the H transpose matrix gives me the list of all possible syndromes. Now what I'm going to do, I know this is bit S1, this is bit S2, this is S3. I'm going to write the product expression for each of these. In the sense, this would be S1, S2 bar, S3, S1, S2 bar, S3. we are going to get a circuit, a combinational logic circuit in the sum of products form. So you write the product expression for each of these syndromes. This would be S1 bar, S2, S3. This is S1, S2, S3 bar. This is S1, S2, S3. This would be S1, S2 bar, S3 bar. And the next one is S1 bar, S2, S3 bar. Whenever it is a 0, the variable would be in complemented form. Whenever it is a 1, the variable would be direct. So this will be S1 bar, S2 bar, and S3. Now, corresponding to these product terms, I can also write the error pattern. The error pattern, because we say if the syndrome matches with the first row of the H transpose matrix, then the first bit position counting from the left is an error, right? So the error pattern would be defined something like this. Okay. So the first bit position in the received vector counting from left is an error. Similarly, if it matches with the second row, the second bit position would be in error. Third row, the third bit position would be in error. And so on it goes. The seventh row, the seventh bit position would be in error. So whichever bit position is in error, that will be marked as 1. Now, if I have to specify what are these bit positions, usually this corresponds to position E1 in the error pattern, E2, E3, so on. This is E7. Okay. So with the knowledge of all this, now it becomes easy for us to draw the error correction circuit. We already have the syndrome calculation circuit. So we had already written the syndrome calculation circuit. I'll not repeat the whole thing. Let me say, I have the syndrome calculation circuit R1, R2 to R7, and I have the syndrome values S1, S2, and S3. Since we are writing for this circuit, I'll just take the respective values. Say we have something. I'm not showing the complete circuit. Okay. We have already written this just now. Now, what am I going to do here? I will simply extend these lines so that I have the bits S1 available, and I will also apply a NOT gate, and so that I will have the bit S1 bar also available. Similarly, just like how we realize a sum of products expression, S2, S2 bar, and S3, S3 bar. Now, you just refer back to the equation. What was the first expression here? It is first bit error means the first row. The first row corresponds to the product expression S1, S2 bar, S3. So what should I do? I'll consider an AND gate, and I'll write that I'll take the corresponding inputs. So what is the value? S1 is one of the inputs. S2 bar is the other input. And S3 is the third input. So all these inputs given to the AND gate. Now, output of this AND gate would be a 1 if S1 is high or S2 is low or S3 is high. So in one of these cases, if what is that? Only if all these three are true, that is S1 is high, S2 is low and S3 is high. Only if all these three things are satisfied, only then we will get the output of this AND gate as high. And if that is high, what would be the, if the output is high, this corresponds to error in bit position 1. Now, how do I correct the code vector, received vector then? I'll add this error pattern to the received, first received bit R1, and whatever result I'm going to get will be the first bit in the corrected code vector C1. Okay, it's as simple as this. We are easily able to draw an error correction circuit using combinational logic. Similarly, what is the next which I should realize? S1 bar, S2, S3. So the second row corresponds to S1 bar, S2, S3. Again, another AND gate. S1 bar, S2, S3. So if there is any confusion, write it down. S2, S3. And if this AND gate output is 1, that corresponds to the error bit E2. And if this is high, whether it is high or low, it should be added to the received bit R2 to get the corrected code bit C2. So every product term or every row of the H transpose, which is written as a product term, will be realized using AND gates like this. Coming to the last AND gate, what is the value? I think I have it as 001, right? So the last one is 001, which means S1 bar, S2 bar, S3. In the sense here, S1 bar, S2 bar, S3, 0, 0, 1. And this corresponds to error bit E7. And correspondingly, if I add the received bit R7, I'm going to get the corrected code bit C7. So this is how we can draw or realize an error correction circuit also in hardware, along with the syndrome calculation circuit. So we can detect errors by finding the syndrome using syndrome calculation circuit, and we can correct errors by using simple combinational logic circuits. I hope you understood this. We'll continue with the next topic in the next class. Thank you.